assign you the addition theorem and probability. So the theorem is statement to addition theorem and probability, the most important essay question. The statement is that E1, E2 be two events of a random experiment, then P of E1 union E2 is equals to P of E1 plus P of E2 minus P of E1 intersection E2. So this is the statement of the proof. So statement is not given in the examination. The question is like that statement to addition theorem. Now first of all we have to write the statement. After that, now this is the proof. So first I take the given data here. What is the given data? What is given? E1, E2 be events of a random experiment. So first I write that line here. Given that E1, E2 are two events of a random experiment. So this is given, two events of a random experiment. Now what we have to show that P of E1 union E2 is equals to P of E1 plus P of E2 minus P of E1 intersection E2. Now we prove this theorem in two cases. This is the first case. The first case is equals to E1 intersection E2 is equals to 5. So this is the first case. E1 intersection E2 is equals to 5. E1 intersection E2 is equals to 5 means the probability value is equal to 0. Set is a null set. Set is a null set means what is the probability? Null set means there is no elements. That is favorable cases is equal to 0. So probability is equal to 0. P of E1 intersection E2 is equal to 0. Already we know one formula. By axiom of the probability, what we have, by the axiom of the probability, we have that P of E1 union E2 is equals to P of E1 plus P of E2. P of E1 union E2 is equals to P of E1 plus P of E2. When P of E1 intersection E2 is equal to 0. P of E1 intersection E2 is equal to 0. Then we have the formula P of E1 union E2 is equals to P of E1 plus P of E2. And in the next step, I take this value as P of E1 plus P of E2 minus 0. Just I apply minus 0 to this value. And this is equals to P of E1 plus P of E2 minus, what is 0 value? Already here one value, 0 is equal to P of E1 intersection E2. So I write this value here. P of E1 intersection E2. What is this? This is the value of P of E1 union E2. That's all. This is the first case of the addition theorem. Therefore, P of E1 union E2 is equals to P of E1 plus P of E2 minus P of E1 intersection E2. So this is the first case. So first case is over. Very, very easy theorem. In the first case, just I take that E1 intersection E2 is equals to 5. Then probability value is equal to 0. If this value is equal to 0, then the formula is P of E1 union E2 is equals to P of E1 plus P of E2. And in the next step, just I apply minus 0 here. And what is 0 value? P of E1 intersection E2. Therefore, this is the proof of the theorem in the first case. Now, coming to the second case, case 2. In the case 2, we take the case is equals to E1 intersection E2 not equals to 5. So E1 intersection E2 not equals to 5. So before starting the second case, I show you here two formulas. The first formula is equals to E1 union E2 is equals to E1 union E2 minus E1. The value of E1 union E2 is equals to E1 union E2 minus E1. Let us check this one. First, I show you the Venn diagrams E1 union E2. What is E1 union E2? So just I take the E1, E2 sets here. This is E1, this is E2, E1, E2. So this part is equals to E1 union E2. Now second one, E1 union E2 minus E1. E1 union E2 minus E1. So what are E1, E2 here? First I take this is E1, this is E2. E2 minus E1. E2 minus E1. Just to subtract E1 from the E2. This total part is equals to E1. This is E1. E1 is equal to this lines part. E2 minus E1, E2 minus E1, subtract E1 from the E2, just taking subtraction of the E1 from E2. So this is the remaining part. This part is equals to E2 minus E1. This is equals to E2 minus E1, this is equals to E1. Now what is the union of these two sets? E1, E2 minus E1. When we take the union, then what we get? Again E1 union E2. Therefore, the formula is equals to E1 union E2 is equals to E1 union E2 minus E1. This is the formula. And the second formula, e2 minus e1 is equals to, and the second formula e2 minus e1 is equals to e2 minus e1 intersection e2. e2 minus e1 is equals to e2 minus e1 intersection e2. Let us see, what is e2 minus e1? This part is equals to e2 minus e1, this part. So here clearly from the diagram what we have, e2 minus e1 is equals to this part, this blank part. And what is e1 part? In the second diagram what is e1 part? This one. Now what is e1 union e2 minus e1? The total part. That is equals to, both are same here. And e2 minus e1 is equal to this blank part. e2 minus e1 intersection e2. This part is equals to e1 intersection e2. Again subtract e1 intersection e2 from e2. Then what we get? Again this part, this blank part. So e2 minus e1 intersection is equal to this blank part. e2 minus e1 is equal to this blank part. So both values are equal. So these two are the very very important formulas with to solve the second case of the theorem. Let us start the second case. So first I take that P of e1 union e2 here. What is P of e1 union e2? P of e1 union e2 is equals to P of, what is e1 union e2? e1 union e2 minus e1. Just replacing that formula here, e1 union e2 minus e1. And observe here, e1 and e2 minus e1 are disjoint sets. This is e1, this is e2 minus e1. This blank part is equals to e2 minus e1. This total part is equals to e1. Both are disjoint sets. So disjoint sets means formula is equal to this value becomes P of e1 plus P of e2 minus e1. Why? Because the two sets are the disjoint sets. Disjoint sets, then union becomes here P of e1 plus P of e2 minus e1. And this is equals to P of e1 plus P of e2 minus e1. What is the value of e2 minus e1? e2 minus e1 intersection e2. Now substituting that formula here, e2 minus e1 intersection e2. That is equals to P of e1 plus P of e2. Now separating the probability to both the sets, P of e2 minus P of e1 intersection e2. So this is the required answer. Therefore, the value of P of e1 union e2 is equals to P of e1 plus P of e2 minus P of e1 intersection e2, which is the proof of the addition theorem, the most important essay question for 7 marks. Very very important theorem. Actually here there is no need to draw the Venn diagrams. These are taken here only for understanding purpose, but these two formulas are important. Here we must remember these two formulas to solve the second case. That's all. Very very important theorem.